Morning, my dear students of class 7. I am your Peacock Miss and I shall take your English 2 class from today. And today we shall start our second summative syllabus of English 2. And at first, I give you the syllabus of English 2. And then we shall start our lesson. So today's lesson is Uncle Possum Hangs a Picture, and it is our lesson 5. So boys, you all open your book. So boys, you all open your blossom book, page number 43, and then you see that is chapter 5 or lesson 5, and the name of the text is Uncle Possum Hangs a Picture, and it is written by Jerome Klapka Jerome, and you also say Jerome K. Jerome also. So boys, now we start our lesson. Boys, at first we know the biography of Jerome K. Jerome. He is an English writer and humorist. His full name is Jerome Klapka Jerome. His nationality is British. His occupation is he is an editor, journalist, author, and also playwright. And he was born 2nd May 1859 in Cladmore, Walsall, England. And he died on 14th June 1927 in Northampton, England. And he is a comic writer and humorist also. He is best known for his comic travelogies like Three Men on the Bumble. The present story is apprised from a chapter in Three Men in a Boat. Now we know an important quote by Jerome Klapka Jerome. The quote is, "Let your boat of life be light, packed with only what you need, a homely home and simple pleasures, one or two friends worth the name, someone to love and someone to love you, a cat, a dog, and a pipe or two. Enough to eat and enough to wear and a little more than enough to drink, for thirst is a dangerous thing." It is written by Jerome K. Jerome. So it is an important quote by Jerome Klapka Jerome. Now we know the theme of Uncle Possum Hangs a Picture. In Uncle Possum Hangs a Picture by Jerome K. Jerome, we have the theme of gender roles, responsibility, inequality, control, ignorance, and independence. So this is the theme of Uncle Possum Hangs a Picture. Now we know the Uncle Possum Hangs a Picture is taken from Three Men in a Boat by Jerome K. Jerome. And you can see also the book that is Three Men in a Boat, the cover page of the boat of the book, and you can see the front page of the book. So this one is the book, this book from it taken. Boys, you can go through the lesson chapter 1, that is unit 1 of Uncle Possum Hangs a Picture, very carefully. And if you have problem, you can WhatsApp me. Yes, I say the summary of Uncle Possum Hangs a Picture, unit 1. Uncle Possum once undertook a common, simple household task. He wanted to hang a picture on the wall, and unfortunately, he took forever and went through many tools and strategies to do this. He made the act more complex than it needed to be. He yelled at people around him for help, but he did not really want them to interfere, and he caused more damage and raised more additional difficulties than he needed to. And whenever Aunt Bozar would ask what was to be done with it, Uncle Bozar would say, "Oh, you leave that to me. Don't you, any of you, worry yourselves about that. I will do all that." So here Uncle Bozar took such a massive problem. When it comes to the task of hanging a picture on the wall, by his acts, he makes everybody in his family perplexed and confused. He thinks that it is he who is doing the job of hanging the picture on the wall. But at the same time, he gets all the family members involved in one or the other subsidiary jobs. He asks people to find his coat while he himself was sitting on it. He had made a mess but looked rightful at his ill-finished job. All this proved to be funny, lovable person, but good for nothing. So this is a very funny text. We know the characters of Uncle Bozar. Number one, he makes the readers laugh. Number two, he feels himself to be a man of ability and skills. Number three, he keeps bragging that he could do any sort of job himself without anyone's help. But in reality, it is number four, but in reality, he involves others in the job, and finally, after messing things up, does the work with imperfection. You remember the word truck? Commotion, that means travel. Sixpence worth, that means having the value of six penny. Cot, that means string. Gravel, that means crawl. Gaping, that means looking with the mouth open.